Welcome to today's exploratory flight of the northeastern area of my domain. As we take off on runway 27 from Windrush International Airport, you'll see to the left in front of the plane a ship on the far side of the river, and that is a ship that was sailed all the way down here from Norway to manage the fish pens, which are used to grow salmon and trout down the Huon River by Huon aquaculture. Today we're going to climb out, and as we reach 500 feet, we'll turn to the right and track off to the north, climb up to 4,500 feet, and track all the way up to New Norfolk. As we turn north along the river, you can see in front of us, in the middle of the river, a reserve which is called the Egg Islands. This is a wildlife reserve for wading birds, I think is the reason why it's a reserve. But basically what it is an accumulation of silt from up the river, and as the Huon becomes an estuary this side of Huonville, the river obviously starts to widen out and to flow very much more slowly, so a lot of the silt is dropped in this area. It looks pretty disgusting from the air, and to be honest with you, it looks pretty disgusting from the roadside at the either side of the river. I really have no idea why anybody would want to keep it, but they do, and there it is. Passing now just to the west of Franklin, you can see that on the west bank of the Huon there, off to the side of Egg Island, and we're continuing to climb now to our cruising height of 4,500 feet. It's a little bit bumpy today, and I'm hoping that as we get a bit higher, the air will clear a little bit. Let's hope anyway. But I really want to take advantage of the nice clear sunny day, because it's the only one I'm going to get for a week or so. While I'm talking to you, I guess I should ask you to ignore the timestamp on the video. We're actually flying in 2018 on the 2nd of July. I forgot to reset the date on my camera after I recharged the battery. Sorry about that, guys. You can see ahead of us and to our right the town of Huonville, which is the major town for this shire, which is the southernmost shire of Australia. As the river narrows, Huonville sits immediately to the north of where the river narrows, and there is a bridge there which makes Huonville the obvious centre for a shire which extends on both sides of the Huon River. This is the last crossing of the Huon as one travels north to south. So it is a natural place for our big town to be. The shire itself, we only have 12,000 odd inhabitants in the Huon Valley Shire, but we cover quite a lot of distance, so you'll see a lot of it in the various films I make of my local flying. So what we're going to do now is we're going to trek over Ranelagh, which is a suburb really of Huonville, to the site of the west of Huonville, and keep on heading directly north over the Wellington Ranges towards New Norfolk. The valley you see extending now to the left as we head off to the west of Huonville is the Huon Valley. Heading off towards Glen Huon and then to Judbury, the Huon River drifts away to the west and has its source over in the wilderness on the to the western side of southern Tasmania. We, however, will continue to head up the islands and go north. Well, we've left the rural lands of the Huon Valley, and we're now over tiger country, the Wellington Ranges. And as I'd hoped, the air is nice and clear and stable up here, and we're somewhere between 4,500 feet and 5,000 feet, and trekking away to the north on an absolutely beautiful morning. The sun's shining, and all is well with the world. It's surprisingly warm up here in the plain, even though I've got the heater turned off. It's probably about -2 outside, but the plane has lots and lots of perspex, and so and stays really pretty warm as long as the sun is bright and cheerful like it is today. Gorgeous day for flying. Coming to the end of our trip across the Wellington Ranges, and if you look to the right at the front of the plane, about 1 o'clock, you can see a valley heading off down towards to the right there, and that at the end of that, and underneath all of that cloud that you can see, is New Norfolk. So we'll go on a little bit, and then we'll track along down that valley and start to descend. Now, controlled airspace, which I'm not allowed in, is about 3,500 feet at New Norfolk, so I want to be 3,000 feet or so by the time I get there. And once I do, I'm going to turn right and follow the Derwent Valley along, and we're going to need to get down to below 2,500 feet as we head down that way towards the Bridgewater Bridge, because as we get to that point, the controlled airspace is everything above 2,500 feet, so I want to be clearly below that. I don't want to find myself in controlled airspace and in trouble. So you can see as we came down towards New Norfolk that the cloud is very, very low cloud. It's really a fog, so we're going to be able to get down to 3,000 feet without any problem. If the cloud had extended up above 3,500 feet and I wasn't able to get down beneath it, I would have had to have turned around and gone back, but we're going to be okay on this occasion. now straight ahead, winding away in front of us, and we're going to follow that around, skirting around that that piece of high ground to the right hand side. If it had been a nicer day, I would have taken us over that and come a little bit tighter in on my turn towards Hobart. But now I'm down again at 2,000 odd feet. I'm starting to find it turbulent again, so I want to give myself plenty of space between me and the terrain. As we continue and begin our turn to the right, you'll see running across the river is Bridgewater Bridge. Now, Bridgewater Bridge is basically a floating bridge, and you'll see it as a line along the across the river, really. And it does open for shipping, or at least it did used to open for shipping, although I've never actually seen it open in anchor myself. I imagine it still works, but who knows? So there we are, Bridgewater Bridge, and now after we get to there, we'll make our turn southwards over Hobart and head down towards Sandy Bay. And Hobart opens up before us, and we'll track along over the western bank of the Derwent here, right over the top of Hobart City and head off for Sandy Bay. As you can see, Hobart is a very photogenic city. It looks gorgeous on a sunny day. Off to the west, to your right, is the is Mount Wellington. Mount Wellington is the beginning of those Wellington Ranges that we crossed over on our way to New Norfolk. This time we're going to go straight past them on the eastern side, and then we will turn a little bit further to the right and track on down towards Bruny Island. Just reaching the city of Hobart now. The city itself is not a particularly tall and impressive city, but it's really quite lovely. Over to your left, the nearest bridge is called Bowen Bridge, and a little bit further on in the distance you can see the Tasman Bridge, which is the major bridge, I suppose, at Hobart, and it takes you across from the city, which is mainly built on the western bank of the Derwent, across towards Cambridge, which is where the Hobart International Airport and the Cambridge private airport are located. City centre is dead ahead, and you can see there's quite a few cranes. There's a fair bit of building going on in the actual city square. The city itself is right next to the port of Hobart, and a good deal of fishing going on there. And straight ahead, you can see beyond the city is a bay, and at the back end of that bay, tall building, is the Rest Point Casino, which is situated just to the west of the university. So the playing fields off to the right of that casino, and you'll see them more as we get there because we're going to fly right over the top of it, are the playing fields of the university, and the university itself is off behind those. Now, absolutely dead ahead at the mouth of the river, you can see what looks like an island. Now, that, in fact, is linked to the eastern bank of the Derwent, and really, I suppose, forms the mouth of the Derwent River. It's a little hard to see where the Derwent River ends and the Tasman Sea begins, Southern Ocean begins. But South Arm, it's called, is linked to its very southeast corner to the mainland on the left hand bank as we look at it. So we're now trekking directly for Bruny Island, which you can see exactly ahead of us, and we're trekking along a body of water which is known as the Doncaster Channel. Bruny Island is really quite a decent sized island, long north to south, in two parts with a very narrow neck connecting them, and it sits at its nearest point very close to the mainland, but it is not in fact connected. There's a ferry that runs from Kettering across to it, but for our purposes we're going to go and land at the airstrip, which is just on the southernmost point of the North Island. Now, if you look straight ahead on the slightly on the right-hand side of the propeller head, you can see a big bay, and beyond that, a piece of land which leads further into the distance to a set of hills that you can see on the horizon. Now, the hills that you can see on the horizon are South Bruny Island, where this we're on at the moment is the end of southern end of North Bruny Island. And if you look carefully at the other side of the bay, you'll see that North and South Bruny are connected by a very thin neck. Now, we're tracking directly towards the entry to the airport at the moment, and the entry to the airport is just this side of the neck. At about 2 o'clock, you'll see an airstrip heading right to left ahead of us, heading out towards the sea. Now, what we're going to do now is we're going to head off to the left of the hill, which is more or less in front of us, and circuit round to the right to land on that runway in the opposite direction to the direction we're travelling in at the moment. So we'll be landing on runway 32. Just for anybody else who's visiting Bruny Island, I made a mistake here, and it turns out that I should have been doing a left-hand circuit on runway 32, not a right-hand circuit. Fortunately, no harm done, but we should all remember that for next time.